Buongiorno everyone, and happy birthday to me. Today is my birthday and I decided to take the train out to Modena, which is just under 30 minutes by train from Bologna. Today I am going to be having lunch at Hosteria Carducci, which is in right in the center of Modena. We're in the home of Ferrari's Formula One and of course the legendary god of opera, Lucio Pavarotti. But instead of doing the typical touristy things, I decided to come out here today to have some typical Modenese food at this osteria. So, here we go.
To lunch, and the waitress here has just brought over a bottle of red wine, and this is a newer wine that they've just introduced to their osteria, and it's called Poggio della Fuga. So let's see how this tastes. She's gonna have me take a sip. Bye. Grazie. Okay. Corposo. It's got body to it, but it's not too rich. It's still a little bit light. It's really good. Mischiato. So there are three types of wine that have been mixed together. So it's Merlot, Cabernet Sauvignon, and Sangiovese to make this special blend, which I've never heard of such a thing, but it works. It's really good. Okay, so my foulois has just arrived, and it is goose liver with a homemade sweet bread, and he gave me a spoon and put this special kind of balsamic vinaigrette on it. So let's see. Good. It's pate-y. Wow, that bread is so good. Delicious. Il pane, mamma mia. Okay, so it's, they say mille foglie, which is like 1,000 layers. So there's just layers with different things inside of this foulois. And then this is a piece of bell pepper with an oil. So let's try. That is the best thing on this plate. Wow, it's a little bit spicy. It's like mustard and white wine, I think. Mm.
partito, però no. Non l'abbiamo avvelenato noi.
Okay, that was dangerously spicy. My whole nose just got set on fire. Ooh. Delicious, but it was really spicy. Wow. I swear this bread is gonna be the death of me. This is the most delicious homemade bread. It's like warm and soft, and I think it's got pancetta in it. I'm not sure, but. This is so good. I could eat this bread all day. Okay, so she just told me that this bread is called gnocco ingrassato. Ingrassare means to like gain weight. So it's kind of ironic, but it is delicious.
And now, picante.
No, perfetto, grazie. And now my salami has just arrived. So they have a whole menu full of different salamis you can choose from. They have them here. And a whole list of cheeses. Now, I am not into cheese. In fact, I wouldn't say I hate cheese, but I'm really not a fan. Like, it's kind of up there with vegetables. I'm not a fan of cheese. But I like to try new things, and we are going to put some honey on our plate, like so. This is a big thing here in Italy. I'm not sure if they do the same thing in France, but it is a big thing here where they have honey with their cheese. And they're really into their cheeses here. So let's try this first one, which is Carduccio. I'm just gonna be American. Yeah, I'm really not into cheese. But let's dip it in the honey now and see if that makes a difference. Wow. With the honey, it brings out the flavor. Ooh, it tastes really good, see? I don't like it on its own, but with the honey, it does make a world of difference. Okay, now let's try this one. Actually, that's not bad. I mean, really, who doesn't like honey? Of course, I guess you could say the same thing about who doesn't like cheese. That would be moi. So, good. Okay, now it's time for my salami, which I requested something that was less salty and a little sweeter because I really don't like salami that's like overly salty. So this one is from here. I don't remember now what the name of it is, but very good. Okay, my first appetizer that I ordered has just arrived, and this is crostino al lambrusco and porcini mushrooms. So I feel like I'm gonna have to cut this. Here's the first bite. It's really good. So what it is, it's like basically a piece of toasted baguette, maybe a very small piece, with porcini mushrooms in some sort of a very warm, soft kind of cream, not cream, but sort of oil. I mean, you can taste the oil, the olive oil. But the toasted baguette is very soft soft, not mushy, but just not as crunchy as it would be if it was just out of a toaster. It's almost like it's been sponged down in a way. Allora, my Carducci burger has just arrived. It's a little mini burger. It's on the appetizer menu. And it's in a dedication to the poet who the restaurant is named after. It smells amazing. I mean, it's so strong, the scent of this burger. And it comes on the side with caramelized onions. But the burger is made from the leg of the pig, and she was saying it's like a clean pork. So I'm not really sure what that means exactly, but I do have to say it looks amazing. So it's really tiny. I don't know what these spices are that they have in here that's making it smell that good, but... That is fantastic. God, those flavors are incredible. Incredible. Wow. I have to taste these onions. God, that's good. Wow. This has been my favorite thing so far. That almost tastes like it has... vinegar. So my lasagnetta has just arrived, and this is a, so it's not lasagna. In fact, this is a very different version of lasagnetta that I've ever seen. Usually lasagnetta comes in a, like a porcelain baking dish. But this is should be very interesting, because what she said was that the way that they cook the pasta is they don't boil it first, so they take lasagna and they bake it in the oven right away, so it's going to be crunchy. And then they have a sauce base, which is made of pumpkin sauce. I was surprised with the pumpkin sauce at that pizza place in Bologna, so I'm anxious to try this. And then there's a cream on the bottom with parmigiano. And I'm not a fan of parmigiano, but as I've said before, I am always open to trying new things. So, this looks good, and the presentation is beautiful. So let's see. It's very salty. It tastes like it has pieces of pumpkin in it too. It's very good. Now it's time for my gnocchette di patate al ragù. So, gnocchi with ragù. Ooh, it smells really good. I love gnocchi. I haven't had gnocchi in a really long time, actually. I never really, either I don't see it on the menu or everything to order it. This is the best thing I've had today. This is delicious, wow. Ooh, I love this. This is my favorite thing for sure here. The sauce is phenomenal, but the gnocchi, wow. The gnocchi are incredible. This is delicious. No, this is the best thing. This is for sure amazing. And I'm getting so full, and I still have more food coming, but this is phenomenal. Because there's just no way that I can finish this right now. I mean, I'm already like close to being stuffed, which is amazing. I haven't even finished my first glass of wine, and they brought me the whole bottle. There's no way I can finish all that either. But I asked her if there's any way they could put extra gnocchi for me in my box to go, because that was incredible.
Maialino di latte, I think. I can't remember. Has just arrived. Basically, it's stinco, which I've shown you guys before. It's a roasted pork. Like, I think it's a pork shank, and it's roasted in the oven, and it's usually made with broth. And on the side, we have mixed mushrooms. When I cut into this meat, it just fell right off the bone, so you know that it's tender, and God, it smells really good. I love stinco. This is delicious. Yeah, that meat is super soft and moist. Oh, it's just right. It's
delicious. So she brought me on her own, by her own accord, this Passito Dolce Matilde, which is some sort of a sweet wine, and she says it goes well with dessert, and I'm waiting for my dessert to come out, so. Ooh, I really like that a lot. That is really, really good.
Well, it looks like I get a birthday cake with a candle in it. So, since it's my birthday, I will go ahead and make a wish. And then I'm gonna taste this delicious looking chocolate cake. So.
Okay, so I don't actually remember what's in this chocolate cake, but it sounded really good on the menu. It's just like crunchy in the spoon with lots of chocolate. My goodness gracious, that looks amazing. I'm gonna have to force myself to eat this whole thing. Wow. This is delicious. Oh my gosh. Mm. I could eat this all day. This and that gnocchi. That gnocchi was my favorite thing. Wow. Mm. Okay, I've finished pretty much everything off the menu and I am stuffed. But this was a great experience here at Hosteria Carducci. And I mean, I'm in love with this chocolate cake. I wish I could finish it all, but I can't because my stomach is just so full. But now I am getting ready to head out because I need to get back to Bologna. I have another appointment soon. Luckily, it is not far from Bologna, so if you're in Bologna or if you're in Modena and you want to get to Bologna, you know, they're very close together with the train. Less than 30 minutes, actually. It took about 23 minutes, I think, something like that. And maybe it was exactly 30 minutes, actually. But at any rate, it's very close. I love the vibe here. Good music. Very knowledgeable staff. The chef could not be nicer. He's the owner and the chef. Just great. It's a cozy little environment. I love the decor and the different poems that they have written on the walls. So in honor of the poet Carducci. So. Yeah, I had a great time here and definitely recommend the gnocchi, the stinko, and the mini burger, but most especially the chocolate cake at the end. And don't forget to get a candle in it if it's your birthday. So, till next time, everybody, don't get lost without me.